Everybody, we are here in the Skype offices in Palo Alto, California, and I am joined with John Thompson, one of the members of the Microsoft Board of Directors. John, thank you so much for joining
us. Thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah, this is very exciting. Now, for those of us who may not know, tell us a little bit about yourself, your background.
Well, I've been on the Microsoft Board now for a little over a year. I am currently the CEO of a small early stage firm called Virtual Instruments. It's all about infrastructure performance management. We are helping customers manage the inevitable physical to virtual cloud migration that's going on. Mm-hmm. I spent 12 years at Symantec, 10 as CEO, 12 as chairman. I announced my intent to retire in the fall of 2008. I stepped down as CEO in 2009. And lo and behold, 1 year later, it became apparent that I had failed retirement when I joined this firm as its CEO. My plan in retirement had been, quite frankly, to invest in early stage, interesting technology companies where I could get involved as a board advisor or, quite frankly, as a board member. Mm-hmm. And lo and behold, this was one that stuck to me, but I've got about 8 or 10 others in my portfolio, none of which I plan to be CEO of, I'll say.
And then you landed at Microsoft, not exactly a small startup.
Not a startup at all, a company that I have admired for many, many, many years. Quite frankly, many of my friends who know me from my days at IBM said, now you competed against Microsoft when you ran the OS2 business, and now you're on their board. What were you thinking? And what I was thinking was that this is one of the true iconic companies, not just in tech, but in our country. And if there's an opportunity to serve in some small way to help this company and use what I have learned over my 42 years in this industry, why wouldn't I want to do that?
Well, because you're so busy and you've got such a diverse background, how would you say your background either complements or works with some of the other board members' backgrounds?
Well, as some people know, I spent a lot of time at IBM. I jokingly say 27 years, 9 months, and 13 days.
2 hours and 12 minutes.
But during that time, I spent time in software, in sales and marketing, and finance, so I had a very diverse background there. My time at Symantec, obviously, I ran a global business that we took from $600 million to $6 billion over the 10-year period. And I hope that what I bring to Microsoft is the experience as a tech leader, the experience as someone who's been on other large company boards. I served on the board of UPS, I served on the board of Fortune Brands, I served on the board of one of the largest energy companies in the US. And so I've got a pretty diverse background of both operational experience as well as board experience that hopefully can help Steve and the other members of the board guide Microsoft in a way that delivers the kind of shareholder value that we hope to be able to create.
Wow, that sounds very exciting. Now, specifically, you're a lead independent director, right?
Yes.
So what exactly is that? What are your responsibilities?
Well, it's as much about helping Steve and Bill devise, along with Brad, devise the board meeting agenda, think through the schedule of the topics that we should cover at what moment in time, to make sure I am the conduit for independent investors back into the company. I'm also the one who leads the discussions with the other independent directors. And so, like, after every board meeting, the independent directors will get together and say, gee, what did we hear? What advice or feedback would we like to give to management? Mm-hmm. And I'm the guy that gets to be the aggregator of those points of view to share with Steve primarily.
Wow. That sounds really interesting.
Oh, it's a great job.
I'll bet people are really interested into what a board meeting is actually like. Can you talk to us about what happens in them? Paint the picture for us. Bring us into the room of a board member meeting.
Generally, five board meetings a year, five on-site, on-prem board meetings per year. And one of those meetings is a strategy meeting. So it tends to cover a multiple day period of time where all of the management team's there, and we will go through in some detail the strategy elements for each segment of Microsoft's business. The other four meetings tend to be focused more on a specific operating unit or operating issue where the team leaders will come in and talk about what they're doing, what the strategic issues are that they're facing, operationally, how are they trying to address those issues, and what ultimately the financial returns will be if we make the appropriate investments along the way. So ours is not a role where we devise the strategy. We certainly are there to provide insight and input That's why you have such a diverse group sitting around the table. Our role is really to say, here's what we think about what we've heard, here's what we like, quite frankly, here's what we don't like, and here's what we hope the outcome will be as the strategy gets executed.
Now, do you literally all sit around a table, or is some of this done virtually?
I would say that the vast majority of the time, everyone is there in the room. I mean, that's the best way to engage.
Yeah.
While occasionally someone has to be on the phone because of travel schedules or whatever, personally, I don't like that. Personally, it's not that I don't like someone else doing it. I just don't like it for myself.
Sure.
Because it's one thing to be able to hear what's going on. It's something else to see the subtleties of the expressions on people's faces,
yeah,
to understand exactly what the nuances might be, because we have a very important role for the literally thousands, if not millions, of shareholders of Microsoft.
I mean, it's fascinating. I would love to be a fly on the wall.
No, you wouldn't.
You'd be surprised. Now, you mentioned a little bit about strategy. Now, what is the board's role in sort of setting and overseeing Microsoft's strategy?
Well, ours is more a monitoring responsibility. And if you were to think about the three broad categories of activity that any board would engage in, first is the strategy right? And is, more importantly, is the team executing well against the strategy? Two, do we have the right financial plans and controls in place to deliver the kind of value that shareholders expect? And three, are we thinking about the human capital of the company in such a way that we can always sustain the leadership and the direction of the company because we're building the right human capital to support that? And so all of our energy should be focused around those three things. Are we doing the right things fiduciarily? Mm-hmm. Are we doing the right thing for people? And does the strategy make sense in the context of everything that's going on? Not to create those things, but to monitor to make sure that the execution is what we expect.
Now, would you say that's something that's consistent in other board
Absolutely.
Leaders? Or is it, then what's unique about Microsoft's board members?
Well, I think what's unique about Microsoft, quite frankly, is just the sheer size and scale and global nature of the company. And while it's in tech, it has a more diverse portfolio of technologies than almost any tech company.
Yeah.
And so when you think about a company like Microsoft, what you want would be a set of directors who have a pretty diverse set of experiences as well.
Now, is there one thing that's Microsoft related, be it a product or an announcement, something coming up in the near future that you're really excited about?
Well, I'm certainly excited about the services and devices or devices and services strategy. I think that's very much in line with where the industry's moving and what Microsoft needs to do. But the statement of the strategy versus the execution of the strategy, candidly, the latter is more important. And so what was just announced today as a corporate restructuring all around devices and services is a very, very important statement for this team, that it's not just what we've said in the press or what we put in last year's annual report. We really do mean this, and we're going to realign the team and our operating philosophies and approaches to support creating a devices and services company. If we do that well, we'll continue to produce the kind of returns that the shareholders have seen over the last few quarters. Microsoft's an incredible company, and when you think about it, they return over $100 billion to shareholders through share repurchase and dividends over the last 10 years. Yeah. Shareholders expect that plus some, quite frankly. They're never satisfied with what you did for me yesterday.
That's right.
And so this new strategy is all about how do
being a shareholder, I know.
How do we do a better job than we've done over the last 10 years?
So what would you say is one of the key points that you'd like to leave us with respect to Microsoft's board or even Microsoft's brand?
Well, Microsoft has a very diverse board, people who bring an incredible amount of experience, skill, and knowledge to the table. While they may not be technologists themselves, they are good, solid, sound business people with great judgment. They have a great passion for the company and for what the company is trying to do, and therefore feel a sense of obligation to be helpful. Our first role is to the shareholders of the company, not to the management team of the company.
Right.
So we're here to kind of every now and then call check. Not sure that's doing what shareholders expect, but by the same token, to be supportive of management as it tries to advance an agenda that may take a little time to unfold. Many shareholders have a short-term interest. The board has to balance that short-term interest with the longer-term view of how you succeed in the tech space. And I think we have a great group for doing just that.
Wow, it sounds absolutely fascinating. You've got a lot of responsibility on your hands, so I appreciate it. And I really appreciate your time. It's been an honor.
Thank you. My pleasure.